Welcome class, Power Logic Designs YouTube channel. Today we are back with another SOLIDWORKS 3D modeling design video tutorial. As we know at the starting of this video tutorial, today we have a guide bracket. This guide bracket is used for motor mounting on wall. This is very simple to create in a 3D if you have a proper dimensions. Before starting today's video tutorial, if you like our previous video tutorial, then like, share and subscribe our Logic Designs YouTube channel, and don't forget to hit the bell icon for notification of latest design videos. So be concentrate on today's video tutorial. Now let's start the video tutorial. First, we need to click or press Ctrl plus N button from our computer keyboard. Now new SOLIDWORKS document window is open. Select part and click on OK option. OK. Now this is our SOLIDWORKS working interface, and in the left side of the computer screen we have guide bracket. This is our today's 3D model. Now read all drawing annotations, dimensions, fillets, rounds from given diagram or image, and set first units to this model. Here I am selecting MMGS on lower right corner. You can see here clearly MMGS is activated. Now first we need to create bottom plate on a front plane. For that we need to select front plane first. Now here I am selecting front plane. Select the front plane and go to the sketch. Now sketch is activated. Now first create bottom plate. For that go to the line, select midpoint line and create one midpoint line. Okay, now your smart dimension, put here 140 mm. Now next one, from this line again select line for creating lower part. Create one vertical line, then angular line, again angular line, then vertical line. Now put smart dimensions. Okay, first vertical line 40 mm, put here 40 mm, 40. Okay, next one, select this point and select this vertical line point and put here 60 mm. Okay, now add relations vertical. Now next one, select this line, select this line and select equal. Okay, now relation is added and our sketch is fully defined. Now next one, add fillets, select this line, select this line. Okay, and put here 20 mm. Okay, again select this line, select this line. Okay, yes. Now again this line and this line. Okay, continue. Now okay, now sketch fillet is done. Next one, close this sketch fillet. Now go to the features, select extrude boss base. Now sketch is automatically selected by a software. Now put here 15 mm. Now okay. Now our bottom plate is created. Next one, we need to create top portion on a right side. okay? For that, we need to select right face of this component. Okay, put a sketch and select the right face for a top portion. Now sketch, set this face. Okay, now sketch is activated. Now press Ctrl plus 8 button for normal to. Now create here top portion. For that, first we need to create two horizontal lines. For that, select line, create one line. Okay, again go to the line, create one line on a left side. Okay, now put smart dimensions. This is 57 mm. Now put here 57 mm. Now next one, this is 3 mm. Okay, 3 mm. Now create vertical line by using line command. Again go to the line. Before that, exit the smart dimensions command. Okay, now line, create one vertical line, horizontal line, and again vertical line. Now put smart dimensions, put here 15 mm. Now our sketch is fully defined. Okay, now extrude this portion. Go to the features, select extrude boss base. Okay, now reverse side. Okay, now put here 140 mm. Okay, now our extrude boss base command is done. Next one, we need to create upper portion. For that, again select right face of this top plate. Now for that, go to the sketch. Okay, first adjust the sketch for the model. Now sketch, select the sketch, select this face. Okay, now Ctrl plus 8 button for normal to. Now next one, we need to convert this horizontal line. For that, go to convert entities and select top line of a top plate. Select convert entity, set this line. Now line is converted. Now again line, create one center line. Okay, at a certain distance. Now put smart dimensions and put over here 40 mm. Now go to a circle. Okay, here I am selecting circle. Now create one random circle and put here 20 mm radius. Now smart dimensions. Okay, diameter is 40 mm. Now our sketch is fully defined. Now create two tangent lines. Okay, for that go to the line, select line, create one line. Now select line, select the circle and add relation tangent. Okay, now again mirror, select this line, mirror about vertical center line, and okay. Now two tangent lines created. Now trim out all unwanted area. Next one, add relation for fully defined sketch. Select both lines and select equal. Now our sketch is fully defined. Again we need to trim out unwanted area, this middle portion. Now okay. Next one, extrude this portion. Go to features, select extrude boss base, Now sketch is already selected by software and put here 15 mm. Now OK. Now extrude is done. We creating hole by using hole wizard. Select the face, sketch on it. OK. Now create one circle. OK. Find out center point. Now create one circle and put here smart dimensions. Smart dimension is 40 mm. OK. Next one. Extrude this circle. Select features. Select extrude boss base and put here 5 mm. OK. Now our top portion almost created. Now go to the hole wizard. OK. For creating hole. Now select third type and select standard ANSYS metric type dowel holes. OK. In a size, show custom sizing, check. Put here 21.42 mm. OK. Now next one, end conditions, throw all. OK. Now go to the position, select 3D sketch and find out center. Select the center. Now hole is created by using hole wizard. Now you can see here hole is created. OK. Next one, rename the tree item for better understanding. OK. Now select rename tree item and put here 21.42 mm dowel hole. Diameter is 21.42 mm. OK. Now next one, mirror this top portion on a left side. For that we need to select mirror option from features. Select mirror option. Select mirror face or a plane. Select right plane. Select features. Select these top portions. I am selecting all features from top portion. OK. Now geometry pattern. Uncheck. OK. Done. Now click on OK option. Now we can see here we creating left side portion by using mirror command. OK. Next one, we need to create bottom plate holes. OK. For that select bottom plate. Now sketch, select sketch and select bottom plate. Now Ctrl plus 8 button for a normal tool. OK. Next one, create first vertical center line. OK. Here I am creating vertical center line first. Next one, again select center line and create one horizontal center line. OK. As per your requirement. OK. Wait. Select center line. Select line. OK. Center line is created. OK. Now put smart dimensions. OK. Here I am putting 50 mm. 50. OK. Next one. Vertical distance 40 mm. Put here 40 mm. OK. Now our line is fully defined. Next one, we need to create line on a right side. Now select line, center line, create this line. OK. Here I am not using mirror command. OK. put here dimension 50 mm 50. Okay, now sketch is fully defined. Okay, we creating these lines for whole wizard. Okay, we need 3 points for creating 15 mm holes. Next one, now again line. Okay, from bottom side. Okay, now put smart dimensions, put here 40 mm. Okay, here I'm putting 40 mm 40. Okay, now we can also create 3 points for holy wizard as particular location, but here I'm creating 3 lines. Okay, there are 2 methods to creating holy wizard, by using point and by using line. Now exit the sketch. Now go to the features and select hole wizard to creating 515 mm holes. Okay, features, hole wizard, select third type hole. Okay, standard and symmetric type double holes. Now put here hole specification 516 mm, because 515 mm is not present over here. Now check the show custom size and put here 515 mm. Now end condition, throw all. Now go to the position and select 3D sketch. Okay, now select all end points from line, and I'm selecting all 3 end points. Now okay. Now our holes are created by using hole wizard. Now rename this tree atom. For that, click right mouse button. Okay, now put here 515 mm double holes. Okay, 515 mm into 3, because there are 3 holes of 515. Okay, this is for only better understanding or visualizing for next person who read this drawing sheet. Okay, next one, we need to create rib by using rib command. For that, we need to create one 2D sketch for that. Okay, now select right plane and go to the sketch, set sketch. Okay, now press Ctrl plus 8 button for normal to. Now convert all required entities. Okay, here I am converted. Now convert entities, select this line. Okay, and select this line. Okay, done. Okay, next go to the line. This line is construction line. Okay, only use for reference. Now select line, center line, create one center line. Okay, at a specified distance. Now next one, now show all hidden lines. Okay, select this eye icon and select view temporary access. Okay, now temporary access is visible. Next one, put here smart dimensions, set this line. Okay, now put here 20 mm. Okay, next one, we need to create one inclined line. Okay, for that press Ctrl plus 8 button for normal to. Now select line, select this point and select this point. Okay, now convert entity, select this line and select this line. Okay, these lines are only for reference. Okay, now trim out all reference lines. Okay, sketch, trim these reference lines. Okay, trim out. Now go to the features. Okay, here's the important tip for your class. For a rib, you need to open one end, okay, as like this video tutorial. Okay, now select rib. Okay, lines are automatic selected by software. Okay, now check flip material slide. Okay, now put 15 mm rib size. Now okay, now you can see here rib is created. Always remember one open end for a rib. Now next one, remaining fillets and rounds of radius 3 mm. For that we need to select fillet command for a rounds and fillets. Go to the fillets and select all required edges. Here I am selecting all required edges from this 3D model. Okay, there are lots of edges are present over here. I am selecting one by one. Okay, from bottom plate, top plate, for a top portion. Okay, select this line. All portions are now selected. Done. Okay, here our 3D model is completed. Okay, this is our guide bracket. This guide bracket used for motor mounting on a wall. The top portion of this plate is hold the motor, and bottom portion or a bottom plate are fixed on wall. That's it class. This is our guide bracket modeling in a SOLIDWORKS. Now you can understand how to model guide bracket in a SOLIDWORKS. If you like this video tutorial, then like, share and subscribe our Logic Designs YouTube channel and press the bell icon for notification of latest design videos, tips and tricks from AutoCAD as well as SOLIDWORKS. Also, follow us on our social media platforms, our Facebook page, AR Logic Designs, Twitter handle, LinkedIn handle, GraphCAD handle. All links are available in our video description, so don't forget to check out. So, see you in the next video. Till then, stay tuned, be happy, be positive, stay safe, and thank you.